Fasten your seatbelt, Connors.
So we're back in New York for the first time in the game. You've been in enclosed buildings.
Never thought I'd see Manhattan this way. Beautiful city. City I almost destroyed. The past is the past, Connors. Let's focus on the future. Or at least the present. Let's go to my apartment.
Alright, welcome back. So it seems that New York City is not only more alive, but more detailed in the graphic setting. Everything, the building seem more crisp, and the lighting, I guess I missed this house. The lighting, everything seems to be beautifully well done by the developer. It's amazing, I love it. One addition I love about this game is the New York City thoughts. Pretty much has Twitter feeds giving you basic updates of what's going on in the game.
Door-to-door service. It's not much, but it's a quiet place to work while you develop the antidote.
You live here?
Are you kidding? I couldn't afford to rent the closet in this place. It belongs to an old friend of my Aunt May. His name's Stan. I'm house-sitting for the summer.
I don't know about this.
Well, the other option is going back to the Lizard's lab. In the sewer.
Oh, this'll do. Where should we set up the lab?
Over here. I guess we start with getting whatever equipment you need to work on an antidote. There's the computer. Kinda old, but it works. A few books for reference over there, not much. Oh, there's a copy of Spice of Life over there. And the television. Guess we should see if we've made the news.
We're stunned today when Kirk Connors, the Lizard himself, escaped from the Beloit Psychiatric Hospital with the aid of costume vigilante Spider-Man. There's no clear motive for the breakout, but police have started a citywide search for these two extremely dangerous fugitives. Now, back to our main story.
I guess that's a yes.
Brilliant. Now they'll think you're the villain, Peter. This is all my fault.
Doc, if you help me come up with a cure, we'll both be heroes. I'll contact Gwen and see what's happening.
Wait, will you tell Gwen? About me?
I have to. Just another reason to create the antidote, right? Now, what are we gonna need to set up your lab?
For starters, all my research. I stored my files on a tablet with an Ouroboros insignia on it. But it won't be easy to locate.
No problem there. I broke into Oscorp once. I can do it again.
Peter, be careful. If Oscorp was continuing my work in secret, we don't know what to expect. This is not the same serum that infected me. It's a virus now.
So I've heard. So, ready to play God?
You do remind me of him. Your father.
Gwen's calling.
Pete.
Gwen, I'm glad you're all right. Listen, I'm with Connors now.
I know, Peter. The whole city knows. You broke him out of prison?
It's a mental facility.
Are you out of your mind? You know what Connors did to the city. He created this problem to begin with.
And he can create an antidote. This isn't the Lizard. This is Dr. Connors.
Can he bring my father back?
Gwen.
I trust you, Peter, but I can't trust him.
I'm sorry. I had no choice, but he's the key to getting you better. And right now, I need you to gather his research for me.
I can't. Dr. Smythe sent it to Oscorp's archive facility.
Just hold on a little while longer. I'm on my way.
Hurry, Pete. I know we're quarantined, but it feels like we're prisoners. Smythe says he's working on a solution.
I'm gonna get you out of this, Gwen.
I hope so.
Gwen's been through a lot.
I murdered her father, Peter.
You didn't kill anyone. It was the lizard.
I want to believe you.
Let's make Gwen believe it.
Alright, so I try not to talk during cutscenes or anything else. I am doing commentary, full video commentary about this game, but pretty much any video game commentary I do will not be voiced during cutscenes. So I will let the cutscenes run so you can enjoy them without my voice. I'm just looking around. I think...
Peter, wait. What are these things?
Oh yeah, I was working on those before everything went down. I call them my spider tracers. Long story short, if I stick this on a police antenna, I should be able to listen to everything they say.
Should?
I haven't exactly had time to try them out yet. No time like the present, though, huh? I'll make a detour on the way to Oscorp Archives.
Alright, so it seems that we now have the full exploration of New York, regardless of the actual mission. I can just free roam, I can get newspapers, I can pretty much do whatever I want. And I think I enjoy that pretty much, specifically for this game and for any game. Open world is the best choice you can do. Looks like I have a comic right here. Got my first of the many.
Let the antenna hunt begin. I'll need to connect all three to get the coordinates.
Got my antenna hub, 1 out of 3 done.
I need to find more antennas.
So the web swing is fluid, I can tell you. I love it. No, it's not. Versus the Spider-Man 3 and Spider-Man 2, you could pretty much web swing anywhere, even in the sky. In this game, you have to be either near any buildings in the air to even swing. Feels and plays like a Spider-Man game, and I love it. Just swinging around and enjoying stuff.
Antenna time. Nice one.
So pretty much for open world gameplay such as Spider-Man, Grand Theft Auto, I'm not going to be doing a lot of commentary because it's just me playing around, me just doing missions, running around, just having fun. Mostly doing missions, I will be doing missions, such as this specific mission, I will be doing commentary. We got the Rhino. Watch out. Alright, so how am I gonna defeat this guy? I'm gonna get behind the SWAT, see if that helps. That didn't do anything. Alright, so it seems if you're having trouble with this specific part, I suggest get Rhino behind the SWAT vehicles so he has an oncoming hit, and then you can just attack him. So if you can get behind this vehicle, let him come at you and just aim. Just take aim. Oh, okay. Trying to dodge this guy. Trying to recreate what I did before, not seem to work. I don't know why. having tremendous difficulty by now.